Yes, dear?
I feel like painting, but we don't have any canvases left.
Oh, okay, let's make some.
Yay! Bigger! Bigger! Bigger!
When I told Dad I felt like painting a picture, I knew he was in for a surprise. I love drawing and painting big pictures, as it's so much fun. My idea was to paint my favorite subject, dragons, as big as possible. I wondered, what would happen if we put two of these big canvases side by side? And then I thought, what would happen if we put four together? Would four be possible? Well, there was just one way to find out. Here's our friend, Chin. He does building jobs for local people after work. To paint such a big picture, made out of four separate canvases together, all at once, they needed to be joined in some way. We had to cut out part of our garden wall. Dad said, if I have such a big dream, whether it's to paint a picture or something else, I shouldn't dream it any smaller, just to make it easier. And promised my painting wasn't going to be 1 millimeter smaller than I dreamed it to be. I couldn't believe my eyes that evening when I saw all four canvases put together to make just one. The next challenge was to find a way to work safely at the very top. Dad said we needed scaffolding. Mom looked online and found a company that rented what we needed by the week. I've never climbed that high before, and I wondered how all the pieces fitted together. I was excited to start my dragon picture, and as the weather was good the next morning, Dad and Mum put the canvases together. Feeling so happy as the time had come to start my dragon painting adventure. I guess there are two ways to do a painting like this. Make a design first in your studio, and if you like it, you copy it onto the canvas. Or the other way is to just draw something without any plan and see what happens. This is the way I like best. I have no idea at all what the painting will look like right now. All I know is it's going to be about dragons, as I love them so much. Actually, the first toy my dad bought me was just after I was born, from a stall by the Japria River, near the hospital in Bangkok. In a corner, tucked away, was a little black soft toy. Dad spied it and thought it was a bat, and he chose that toy for me. The stall owner thought he was crazy to buy such an ugly looking thing. So, on my first day of life, I had this little toy next to me. And some years later, I discovered it wasn't a bat, but in fact a dragon. Not just any dragon, it was Toothless from the film How to Train Your Dragon. To this day, 7 years later, this little Toothless is still my favorite toy, and I think it's beautiful. I felt very safe at the top of the scaffolding, as I had an extra guardrail around me so I couldn't fall. When the sun came around in the afternoon, Dad made a shade with a sheet of canvas so I wasn't too hot. In the early afternoon, I stopped drawing for the day. I had the best time ever. A At the end of the day, the canvases were brought into the house in case it rained overnight and screwed back on again in the morning. I was excited to try and finish my drawing. The weather was fine, so I just carried on where I left off yesterday. In the design, I have a mixture of big dragons, medium and small. There's no real up or down in the picture. It's more of a pattern. But at the bottom of the canvas, my dragons are resting in the flowers on a hot day, just like today. It was an extremely hot and humid day, so Dad put the scaffolding close by with a sheet of canvas to block out the sun, and I was able to finish my drawing. So far, the weather has been kind to us, considering it's the rainy season. Dad and Mom put the canvases together in the morning so I could start the underpainting as my drawing was finished. I like using acrylic paints best. One way of making a painting is to imagine a main color for the picture. For some reason, I was in the mood for shades of blue. On the color wheel, on the right side of blue is green, on the left side, violet. As these colors are neighbors, they will harmonize very well with blue. The following day was the time to add the complementary color to blue, orange. Just in small amounts, so the blue would always stay the main color. The paint is really thin up to now, a little bit like watercolor. As I just wanted to know what the painting would look like with these colors before I put on the detail. The next day I wanted to work at the top, so Dad and Mom set up the scaffolding and the extra guardrail at the top. In my last painting, I got used to climbing ladders. And although this is a much bigger picture than I've done before, I found I actually liked being up there at the top the best. As luck would have it, I managed to get this far in the picture before the monsoon rain arrived. Our plan B went into action. And we lifted all four canvases over the balcony and into my studio. A delivery motorbike came by our house with a mysterious parcel for me. Dad and Mum surprised me with my very own dragon wings, tail and mask. My parents rented the scaffolding 2 weeks ago, and today was the day it had to go back. No worries, as I could finish the details on my painting indoors. Painting makes me feel happy. Always makes me feel like dancing and jumping about. To make the brush strokes and colors connect together in my painting, when I come to the edges, we put two canvases together. There's enough space in my studio to put two side by side. We clamp the canvases together so they don't move about, and I can work on the details each day in between my lessons. Our dogs are good house dogs, are very friendly, and like to have human company. The good thing is, they get on well together, too. I like making textures by painting and rubbing around with a cloth and going over and over. Because the canvas is white, The colors look brightest when the paint is quite thin. In between my lessons and playing with friends, I kept on painting my picture, as usual, day after day, until it was finally finished. To do this, we sometimes put the canvases side by side on the easel so I can make sure the edges blended together between the two canvases and sides. I used the same style for this picture as in my previous paintings. Sometimes the outlines of the dragons are shaded on the outside to make them stand out, and sometimes on the inside. It depends on the color of the background. This painting is a high key painting, so there's no really dark colors, just the eyes, I guess. The painting goes from light to middle tones, and that's it. I thought of calling the painting It's Summer for Dragons. I was really curious to know what the four canvases put together would look like. Here are a few details from It's Summer for Dragons. It wasn't just a painting to me, it felt more like an adventure. I discovered you can have a big adventure just staying at home. Painting dragons, fireflies, flying dinosaurs, glowing bees and butterflies on such a big canvas without any plan felt like an adventure. Bright colors are magical. They make me feel like dancing, and I love that feeling. This past month was a happy summer dragon adventure I'll never forget. Also, it feels very special to share this painting adventure with you. Thanks for watching. Stay safe.